So the focus of my dissertation is this biogeographic feature called the Rupununi portal. And what the Rupununi portal is a vast savanna in southern Guyana on the border with Brazil. And what happens is during the rainy season, this region floods and allows for this connection between the Essequibo drainage and the Amazon River. And so this allows for potential movement of aquatic taxa organisms to move around. This is important for understanding evolutionary processes of generating the great diversity that's in the Amazon basin, but also maintaining that diversity. Actually, my very first trip, I had just started at Auburn, and I talked to Dr. Armbruster, and he was like, "Do you want to go to Guyana?" And I was like, "Okay." And so that very first expedition really changed the course of the next couple of years and my dissertation research. I didn't know I was gonna do research down there. So, and then after that, I did two expeditions that were part of my dissertation fieldwork. And then the final trip was a trip working with a television show that wanted to kind of highlight the area. A friend of mine has a television show with a travel channel called The Wild Within. And the premise of the show is to study different, or to travel to different communities and learn a little bit more about their hunting and gathering techniques. And so he knew that my research was in this remote area in southern Guyana, so he wanted to, and he knew that I'd worked closely with Amerindians for several years, and so he wanted to come down there and do an episode working, hunting and fishing with the local Amerindians. This was different just because we got to, it was solely about hunting and fishing with the Amerindians and learning a little bit more about their connection with the forest and their food source and the way that they prize their, they just value and appreciate the abundance that it allows, it gives to them, you know, in terms of food source. And so they have this very unique relationship with it, which I think we get away from sometimes here because we're not as connected to our food source like they are. This is an area where you have giant anacondas, giant anteaters. You have the giant river otter. I mean, you know, biodiversity that's just rare. An area that's going to be able to maintain such a vast number of different types of organisms is indicative of a place that is pristine, that is not threatened. So this is an area too that very little research is done in this area. It's very difficult to access. You know, I was fortunate to, along with Dr. Armbruster, through grants from the National Science Foundation, to be able to go into these areas because expeditions were really expensive just to access these points, not just vehicles to get to the river, but then, you know, fuel to go upriver for several days. Because once you get there, you want to make the most out of it and you want to be able to, you know, access as many places as you can. It's wide open in terms of new species, things that have still yet to be quantified and observed. I mean, I think that is my biggest concern for this region. I feel like there isn't enough research that's going on there to protect this area, and there's the encroachment of development from the Brazil side into the southern part. If I could highlight anything in my research in this area, it would be to the conservation, the abundance of wildlife there, the resources. It's sort of a magical place to me.